Welcome to Unite Now, where we bring unity to you, wherever you are.
Hello, thanks for joining. Welcome to today's Unite Now presentation on adding voice and chat communications to your games with Vivox. My name is Ashley Alicea, and I'm a games evangelist at Unity. And as an evangelist, I spend my days working with new Unity features and helping developers learn how to integrate them into their games. In particular, many of you in the past year have asked me about how to set up in-game communications, so I'm excited to show you Vivox and how it can be used to create engaging social structures and environments for your games. The first portion of my talk will cover what Vivox is all about and how it works, but then I'll jump into the editor so you can see it in action and learn how to start adding it into your connected games. Whether you're an enterprise developer looking to integrate solid voice communications for your next big game, or an indie dev who wants to learn the ropes using Vivox's free plan, you'll learn a lot in this session. We'll also have a Q&A over on the Unity forums, and I'll share the link for that at the end of the session. With that said, let's go ahead and get started. Vivox was acquired by Unity a little over a year ago, but has actually been around as a service since 2005 and is the market leader for real-time voice communications for video games. In the 15 years since they founded, they built up the tech and expertise needed to run voice at scale for games of all sizes. This has forged Vivox as the mature platform and experienced team that it is today. Over 500 companies are using or integrating Vivox right now. Even the biggest titles in the business use the service, like Fortnite or games by Blizzard. All of this has resulted in the service being battle-tested and optimized over time to create the best possible experience for your players. It also brings you the fastest time to market for game chat services. Implementation time is of course dependent on your game's infrastructure, but with help from our documentation and SDKs, the average setup and implementation of Vivox into your projects takes about 2 days. This gets you the functionality that you need quickly, saving you all the time that you would otherwise be spending to create your own custom voice solution. It also means that you can spend your time focusing on what we love as game creators, making our games great. The Vivox solution is not only managed and hosted by us, but it's massively scalable. It serves over 120 million monthly active users across the globe, which adds up to 100 billion minutes a month of voice. There's over 200 ways to integrate Vivox into your projects, and it all has a 99.9% uptime guarantee. It also works on many platforms with cross-platform support. The API and feature set behind Vivox is consistent across all of its supported platforms, which enables you to set up cross-play between them all if you so wish. You can use Vivox for apps on Android or iOS devices with ARM architectures, Xbox One, PlayStation 4, Nintendo Switch, Google Stadia, macOS 10.9 and above, and Windows 7, 8, and 10. This all works because of the hybrid solution that powers Vivox. Let's say you have a new game launch, an in-game event, or another happening that will cause a heavy spike in players. The thousands of bare metal servers that support Vivox are augmented by bursts into the cloud during times of high usage or growth. This lets the service respond quickly and support that growth no matter how it arrives. A great example of this was the Marshmallow concert in Fortnite, which had 10 million concurrent players participating. Vivox only received a week's notice to prepare, but thanks to the flexibility of the service, it was able to scale its footprint across several hundred additional servers. Vivox also kept voice comms powered throughout the game's recent Travis Scott concert, which had over 12 million concurrent players. When PUBG launched, they experienced a tenfold growth beyond their initial expectations for peak concurrent users, reaching over 3 million users at once. Because of the hybrid setup of its infrastructure, Vivox was able to scale their growth alongside PUBG and keep players communicating. Because Vivox is a service, we handle all of these infrastructure concerns for you, like the massive audio calculations and networking required to make the service work. This takes logistical concerns like network security, bandwidth, and more off of your plate. Once you integrate the SDK in your game, you'll have everything you need for working voice communications. So what features does Vivox actually give you? Everything you see here and a lot more, but let's go over some of the highlights. 2D and 3D channels. I'll explain more about how channels work in a bit, but basically they are where voice communications are handled within the Vivox system. Channels can have thousands of players or just a few, and they are platform agnostic, so cross-platform users can join the same channel. When working with Vivox, you'll come across two types of channels. In a 2D channel, you can hear all of your designated players at the same volume, like the standard squad chats we're familiar with in games. In comparison, 3D positional channels take into account a player's orientation and location in the game to make the player's voice sound closer or farther away from others. Players can join up to 10 channels. So, for example, someone can be in a team chat 2D channel and have general 3D positional audio around them as well. In addition to group voice and chat, players can also direct voice and chat to individual users. There's also moderation tools for muting bad actors, kicking them out, and more. There are further updates that are coming for toxicity and accessibility. The in-development server-side recording and persistent message archive tools will enable players to record audio and messages if another player is being toxic and a report needs to be made. You could set it up so that the data is sent when a player hits a report player button. CSRs can then go in and check to see if offensive action was committed and take the appropriate follow-up steps. We're also working on the ability to transcribe spoken word to written text and vice versa for added accessibility, support for toxicity moderation, CVAA requirements, and more. There's also a couch co-op mode in development that will allow multiple players in the same room and using the same console to use voice chat at the same time. As we're talking about features, I want to take a bit to clarify a couple of concepts behind Vivox: channels and users. Think of channels as chat rooms that users can join to communicate with each other. Now, something key about channels and users in regards to privacy concerns: both are ephemeral. We don't store info about users or channels on our backend. They are created on the fly as needed for each session by the SDK. When no longer needed, they are deleted. There's no extra security needed to handle this beyond Vivox access tokens, which are granted by the server to users so that they can connect to the service. A standard gameplay session using Vivox can look like this graph. You can start by initializing the Vivox voice client, a class in our SDK, to start the user login process. You'll want to log the user in as soon as possible. Since it's a network call that needs allocated resources, it could take up to a few seconds when joining a channel for the first time. So sign in users the first chance you get to avoid latency. Users stay logged in as operations are completed, such as moving players between channels or responding to SDK events. When you're ready to end the session, you can log the user out and terminate the Vivox client. Now that we've reviewed how Vivox works, let me show you how easy it is to get started and have a project up and running in the editor. Your first step is to create an account on the Vivox developer portal, developer.vivox.com. This will be your key gateway to getting all the tools, information, and resources you need to set up Vivox for your games. Once you create an account, you'll have access to the service's online documentation, help center, forums, app and developer credentials, SDK library, and best of all, a sample Unity game project equipped with Vivox features for you to test out and learn from. If you're familiar with Unity tutorials, you'll recognize this as a version of our Tanks project. You can download and access these resources using the Vivox plugin via the Unity Asset Store, which I'll do for this example. Regardless of where you get your downloads, you'll need a Vivox developer account to use the service. Once that's set up, visit your app dashboard on the developer portal to create a new application for your game. Click on Create New Application and add the name and applicable genres for your game. Press Continue, select Vivox for Unity, and add all the applicable platforms that your game will support. Once you complete this, you'll be taken to a page for your application where you can grab all the developer credentials you need to activate Vivox in the sample Unity project. Once you have Vivox installed and an application created in your Vivox dashboard, navigate to the sample project by going to Assets, Vivox, Samples, Tanks, Unity Game Sample. Your next step is to open Main Scene in the Scenes folder. In the hierarchy, select the game object called Vivox Voice Manager, which contains a script of the same name. Add all your API info and keys to their applicable fields in the Vivox Voice Manager component. Note I'm adding in some temporary credentials that I've been able to reset through the developer portal dashboard in order to keep things secure. Be sure to also add the sample's main scene and game scene to your project's build settings. You're now ready to jump into the game. As I mentioned earlier, the Tank Sample App project is an excellent resource because it shows exactly how you can implement the Vivox SDK, and it contains scripts that you can copy and use for your own games, namely the Vivox Voice Manager class. It's an incredible resource that's implemented as a singleton and ready for use out of the box for other projects. It handles session and channel management, text chat, and more. It also holds your Vivox credentials, like displayed earlier. Also note, this project does not represent the only way to set up Vivox for your games. For this example, we decided to draw upon a format similar to MOBA games, where the user alternates between lobby, team, and match chats. For your games, you can have your own setups, like having a single channel for all players to chat with, like an MMO. Let's enter play mode so we can go step by step through how Vivox runs here. Know that I also have a build of this game sent to a friend, and they just opened it on their computer as well. We're both logging in now, and once we're in, we're placed in this lobby area where we can use voice or text chat to communicate as we wait for a match. For this, a 2D voice channel is being used in the lobby so all users can be heard equally. You know what? You can unmute if you're ready for a match. How about that?
I'm ready for a match.
All right. Why don't you go host it? Notice the updates we've been getting in the console log as we started the game and the login process. These logs are an incredibly helpful addition to the project that keep you posted on all the Vivox processes that are happening as the game progresses. For example, when I begin the game, you can see on the networking side that a client is started for the game, and Vivox detects this change and logs me in. You can also see that I'm assigned a unique ID to identify my account for this session. Know that most of the SDK functions in Vivox are synchronous, and in this case, we're subscribed to a login state event that calls join channel as soon as we're logged into the system. In this sample game, voice for each user is enabled and unmuted when they log into the lobby. So whenever we talk or make noise, you can see the speaker icon next to our name start animating. We're able to activate this speaking indicator thanks to Vivox's on-speech detected event, which we can see getting triggered in the console here as I talk. We have options to mute ourselves or other users, and in addition to voice, we can also type messages to each other, which uses send text message in the Vivox Voice Manager script. The other user is now initiating a match, so I will go ahead and join them. In the console, you can see that I'm disconnected from the channel I was placed in for the lobby, so my voice input can be directed into the new channel created for our match. Now we're both in the game and can battle against each other for ultimate tank supremacy and still have a friendly chat the whole time.
Hey.
Oh, I can hear you.
Yeah, how's it going?
All good.
That's good. Just being a tank, right?
Can't hear you anymore.
Can't hear me now?
You can see that we only hear each other if our tanks are close together. That's because voice for the match is being handled with a 3D channel using positional audio. The tank setup script is a good reference for how to set up your desired game object to use positional audio. There's also a positional voice class you can copy as well to handle the position and orientation updates that Vivox needs for positional channels. We can see how these are applied when selecting the complete tank prefab. You can see in the inspector the fields used to assign the object to be tracked, what its audible distance should be, and more. It's worth noting that 3D channels work similar to 2D channels in that they both use participant added or participant removed events. But while 2D channels call these events as people enter and leave the channel, 3D channels call these events when players enter or exit the audible and conversational distance spheres. Once we're done with the match, I can leave play mode, and you can see that Vivox automatically logs the player out and ends the client session. There's a lot more to discover in the sample, so go ahead and download it now to check out everything it covers. To wrap up, I have great news for those of you ready to start learning and using Vivox. We want to enable creators of all sizes to use our best-in-class tools, just like the AAA games using Vivox today. So we have a free tier of Vivox available to everyone. The service is free for games with up to 5,000 peak concurrent users per month. You'll only get charged for usage once your game has over 5,000 users playing at the same time. For those of you who want to take it up a notch with our enterprise plan, you'll get access to dedicated servers for your game, unlimited scale, a dedicated integration support team, and 24/7 ops support. Thank you again for joining us for this session. Remember to visit the Vivox Developer Portal to get the credentials and resources you need to get started. If you have any questions or would like to learn more about what was presented today, come join us over on the Unity forums. We have a dedicated thread for this talk, linked here, where the team is ready to answer your questions or share more details about what was presented today. Until next time, stay safe, have fun, and see you on the forums.